Welcome back to The Rhode Show. This morning in The Buzz, we are talking savings. It turns out we as Americans aren't so great at this practice. In fact, 66 million Americans have no money saved for an emergency. That is according to Bankrate.com. Generation X is the worst. 33% of 36 to 51-year-olds haven't saved a cent, compared to 27% for all others age 18 or older. It's really tough. It's tough for a lot of people to be able to put any money aside for an emergency, because you're always told, make sure you have an emergency fund in case something goes wrong. If you drive, if you drive a car and the car breaks down, instead of having to charge it, you can use money for that. If you're a homeowner, God forbid something happens, always have a backup plan or some money. But for a lot of people, it's hard to do.
It is near impossible.
It's impossible, yeah.
I have some. Very little.
Right, yeah.
But if I had kids or something, oh no, I don't think I'd have any.
Right.
I think it would be impossible.
To save
just
money.
Given loans and bills and just day-to-day stuff. And you try and pinch your pennies enough, but at the same time, you gotta live your life.
Yeah.
You can't, stop yourself from experiencing things or doing certain things. You can be a little more, not to say stingy, but you can be a little frugal at times, and I think that's a good balance. But you gotta live your life. You can't keep saving so much that you then get to a point where you can finally use it, and
it's too
late. Kind of unable.
Right, you can't use it anymore. I mean, they say all the time, make sure you pay yourself first. That's what they always say. I don't know really what that means, but that's what they say. Pay yourself first. So I'm going to pay myself first, and then I'm going to go out and enjoy what, what I want. But this, you can see how people get into deep credit card debt. Because they want
certain
things.
Don't get all those credit cards.
Right. The credit card companies will send them out to you one right after the other. People sign them up. Mm-hmm. They max out these credit cards because they want to do certain things, or they're unable to save any money, and things break down. You need things. People charge it.
Yep.
And it's just a constant cycle of building up these credit card debts, and then you bury yourself.
Yeah. Well, but and it is hard, because if you do have certain situations where they do pile up on each other, and okay, emergency funds, just wipe the credit card, like you said, I feel like that's what it should be for.
Yeah.
Don't go on shopping sprees all the time and charge it all to your card, because, knock on wood, something might happen to your car, like you said, and then you're going to start tapping into those funds that now you don't have anymore.
People think, because the credit cards are so easy to use, you go to a store, you see something you like, you swipe the card, and it's like, oh, this is great. Hey, they gave it to me. Well, guess what? Eventually, the bill comes in the mail, and you got to pay for it.
Right.
And that's when people are like, oh, now what am I going to do?
I just think it's difficult in that age range, that 36 to 51. I picture a lot of people maybe having families and all extra expenses that come with that too. So maybe that's why that certain generation struggles a little
and
bit
still,
more.
And still paying off college for a lot of people too.
Oh yeah.
Forever.
That'll be me.
Yeah.
All right, Brendan, do you struggle with saving money?
I'm going to open up my wallet to show you how much I have saved right in there. Look down deep, everybody. I am not making it rain. There's pocket lint and mothballs in there, but you got to be careful. You got to save that money. Here, most importantly, is what our social media friends are saying about this topic today. If they aren't putting away money, hopefully they've saved up some comments for us. Jane Pear gets us started today. This area is a hard one for saving. Cost of living is high and salaries are low. We haven't really rebounded from the recession. Billy Cardi adds, how is it possible to save when cost of living is so high? Food and gas prices keep going up, and we have no jobs to try and recover what we lost. Oh, everyone's so optimistic today, aren't they? And lastly here, this guy will turn it around, putting it all into perspective as only he can. Hank Sinatra Jr. shares, my savings isn't cash. For my rainy day fund, I am sitting on a complete set of Ace Ventura Pet Detective trading cards. Ooh, maybe I'll make him an offer. Very nice. Thanks for commenting this morning, you guys. And as always, we want to hear from all of you. People ask me frequently, they say, Brendan, you marvelous human, you, how can I get my name on TV? Well, by commenting on our daily buzz topic between 7:30 and 8:30 a.m. each day. Just give us a like on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. All of those are at The Rhode Show. Please join us and contribute to the daily discussion.